people who ran the community were important, and if you wrote something about it, they didn't like it. And Albert's parents lived there, and his father was, you know, the head of the symphony and one of the first doctors in town, and so he took a lot of crap. And we learned how to live with that. We learned how to live with people who didn't like us. There was a point in our newspaper when we wrote a lot of great stories, and we were able to clear a restaurant. So if we walked in, everybody got up and left. great, because, you know, it's never too crowded. And we learned that you can fail and you don't die. Mm-hmm. And that's powerful, because if you've never had a major failure when everybody sees that economically you didn't do it, then you're afraid of everything. I was taught as a child and really have a strong belief that what you do matters. I think, in common with most of the people who work in this company and companies like it, think that you need to have a purpose. You need to have some direction in which you're trying to put pressure on society to make it better. And this is a fantastic gift. I started out in journalism, veered over to being a lawyer to feed my family, found that really, really depressing, and came back to publishing, journalism, education. Education and journalism are two things that I really believe have an opportunity to change the world. So I get to work in those things, that's why I do it. Mm-hmm. I get paid really well for doing it, and I work pretty hard to do it, but I do it for that purpose. And I think most people work for a calling and not for a job.